what's your experience with at least reaching for the basic levels, and what's in the way of success there?
So I think that to be very ambitious, paradoxically, we have to be less ambitious, and that going back to what Helen was saying. Teachers typically are under the pressure to complete curriculums that have been designed for students of another generation, meaning the elite. And so in order to finish this curriculum, they have to leave a large fraction of the kids behind. And it seems that parents, in some sense, share this belief that education is a little bit for the elite. So for example, a study found in Madagascar that 70% of parents who thought that when children complete secondary school, they're going to get a government job, when the reality is only 33%. On the other hand, they underestimated the returns of going to primary school. So there seems to be a shared belief between teachers and parents that some children will make it until the end, and that some other kids will not really make it. And so it's not really worth focusing on them. And so I think that interventions that have been quite successful at improving learning levels have really deeply understood this problem and have basically assumed that it's not just education for all, but learning for all, and that it's feasible. So for example, education interventions that aim to target instruction at the child's level, like remedial education using volunteers, which is what Pratham does in India, and something that has been replicated in Ghana with a youth employment program, is very effective.
It is eminently possible in anything but like 8 languages in the world to make nearly everyone, except for the profoundly learning disabled, literate in something like 4 months. I use the word 100 days, 100 instructional, considering 1 instructional hour a day and considering even absenteeism. Let's say the first half of a school year. It becomes critical, in fact, in the very low-income countries, to make the students at least able to decode letter by letter and even slowly in the first half of the school year before they drop out. There are big issues involved in literacy that we in the neuroscience of literacy that we need to understand. A fair amount of practice is needed, and yet the textbooks, which often do not exist because textbook procurement fails in the low-income countries, the textbooks are made for the middle class with lots of pictures and very little text. The children who have no one at home to read with them will never get enough practice. So, strangely, you have to make textbooks without any pictures, but big and broad text to coincide with the parameters in our brain about spacing and size until the children get habituated after X number of hours, and we don't know what that is, to reading small letters. These things that we never think of as in the middle class are huge issues for the children, and they're even bigger issues for the adult illiterates.
There are other ways target instruction at the child's level that may not involve the community, that could involve technology as well. So the same concept, but it's a very different sort of ways to get there. So for example, you can use computer-assisted learning programs or now cell phones possibly to help the children learn at their own pace by adapting to sort of their level.
It is complex for reading, but when we talk about literacy and numeracy, we are talking about, I always repeat it, complex reading, but also understanding numeracy and using other skills. So to what level should we, or how much time are we going to spend into this? We have seen programs claiming to make people literate, I would just schematize, in 2 hours. And of course we have 4 weeks, 2 months. So, but in reality, all of these programs at the end have achieved maybe minimally something. And in reality, the majority has been left out. So I'm hearing here that you need to spend much more targeted individual cases to obtain the result we are aiming for all.
Of course, 100 days will get students to actually barely, the lowest students, to actually barely decoding. But that's a whole lot more than what we're getting right now. From then on, they need to get a whole lot more practice in order to speed up. Because to understand text, we need to have a minimum speed of like 45 to 60 words per minute.
The expectations on teachers are not necessarily set right. And so it is very important to have very clear and achievable goal for teachers if we want to make progress.
By the way, the teachers do not need to be either highly educated, as you say. Anybody basically almost literate can teach the students through 4 or 5 activities that are really basic, particularly going from one child to another and giving some corrective feedback. 5 seconds of it, which without which humans actually cannot learn. And this is what is missing at this moment, because as Annie is saying very wisely, the teachers focus on the very best. They interact with them, and they neglect everyone else, who will drop out in due time because of the perennial beliefs that under this system, very few can do it.
To provide basic literacy as such to adults doesn't take much time, and also can be achieved for 80% of a learner. Quite easily, most of the countries have done it. But then if you reach this, the next 20% left are difficult moving targets and having also specific needs which also need to be addressed, targeted almost individually. So your mass approaches will deal with mass illiteracy, but when you achieve a high, stable level, you need to go into individualized learning and teaching.
Okay.
In order for someone to be a learner, they have to become fluent readers so that they can effortlessly take in information. They also have to have some elements of prior knowledge, because you cannot remember material whose related concepts you don't know. You actually, the way our knowledge networks, our cognitive networks are set up, you need to have one item and be able to hang a hook to hang the next item. So if you don't know much about a topic, you will not remember, you cannot learn. And of course, it snowballs.
Based on my observations in rural areas of Bangladesh, I think what is important is institutional innovation. For basic learning or any other learning, what you need is more synergy involving schools, families, community, government agencies, and even NGOs. And the next thing, for basic skills, what is important is what materials are being used and how. From real world examples right in a village, there are opportunities to teach students. But what I see, that learning is going through the old textbooks. And I firmly believe that textbooks are necessary, but textbooks never change the world.
Yeah, and Adama, you had made a point earlier that just because someone has become basically literate doesn't mean they use their literacy. It isn't automatic, and they maybe have not been shown why it matters to them.
It's definitely not automatic, and that people don't learn or read to learn. And this is something we should be able just to promote and understand that people are born learners, and they have all the capacities, but our system is somehow shrinking this ability because we put them into some task which are, in fact, limiting their capacity to go beyond this. What we need is going beyond these basics and doing this in a very serious way in all our learning institutions. And I'm insisting, learning institutions, not only at school.
The question then is, will the world take up the cognitively efficient methods for the very poor? As we are giving the financing, or are we getting tangled into various philosophical discussions?
I think a future system would be about learning, not just for children, but learning about the system. So you need constant sort of experimentation and evaluation to understand where to invest.
In all honesty, I see in the future a need of assistive technologies to, because we're we're getting close to the limits of information processing, of how much our brain can do.
So you would have not just teachers, but maybe in the community, parents, older siblings, also involved in helping their peers and ensuring that they don't get left behind.